Afternoon, friends. Let's cut through the niceties. We got a big problem in the neighborhood and not a lot of time to deal with it. I only want to make this speech once. Is anyone else at home? Good. I overheard the health inspector say that there was a serious outbreak of yucky fruity caucus at the local market. Food poisoning. Oh yeah, real bad. The market's closed, but any groceries that may have come from there could be contaminated. Now the health inspector's got vacation plans, and he thinks the bad news can wait until he gets back. I'm telling you, it can't. You know the symptoms of food poisoning, right? No? Well, first you get the sweats from overheating, then come the arctic bitter chills, then the wrenching stomach cramps, your joints all stiffen, you swoon, and finally you see spots and hear the tinkling of little bells, and then... Of course, years of being a lab rat has made me immune to bad food. Can you show me where the food is kept? I need to do some testing. Thank you. Now, as you may have noticed, there were no outward signs of anything wrong, but looks can be deceiving.
Are my eyes playing tricks on me? Or are you two numbskulls feeding premium chow to a disgusting street rat?
Oh, disgusting street rat? I prefer to think of myself as a concerned friend with important connections at the County Board of Health. I could have minded my own business, but I care way too much about total strangers getting food poisoning. You are familiar with the symptoms. First, you break out in tropical sweats. Then you get the arctic chills. Then the stomach cramps. You stiffen, swoon. And by the time you see spots and hear the tinkling of tiny bells, it's too late. You're a goner.
What are we gonna do?
Glad you asked. While I continue conducting my test here, you're going to wait in the front yard and bark up a storm when your owner gets home so I can wrap up my review. Sound like a plan?
Sure thing, Mr. Rat.